Welcome, thanks for joining me. In this video, I'm gonna have you guys come along with me as I pack up my trailer. As close friends may know, but what I haven't exactly posted on my YouTube channel is that Whiskey and I qualified for the North American Affiliate Championship Show, which is held in conjunction with the NRHA Futurity in Oklahoma City. And we are in Washington State. So it was kind of a lot of thought went behind whether or not we were going to go or not. And at the end of the day, I just felt like this was just such a big opportunity that I just don't know if we're ever even going to qualify again. So the decision was made that we're going to go to Oklahoma. And this nice big trailer behind me, actually it's smaller than my old one, just bought this 2 days ago. Not exactly for the trip, but was wanting to get another trailer anyway. And then this kind of just figured if we could get it in time before leaving, then it'd be great. It's a 2019 Trails West, and you'll see inside and stuff with the rest of the video. But yeah, today I'm gonna get the majority of the interior packing done, and you can join me to see what I bring and how I pack it. So this cool device is called a stall paddy, and I bought it for a living quarters that I had, and it basically allows you to have like a stud wall, but it's easily movable to any other trailer, and it's padded. And so what I end up using it for is that I use the third stall as storage, which I'll have my hay in there. And then this makes me feel a lot better about Whiskey being next to the storage, and he can't, you know, accidentally hit a hay bale, or if something falls, it shouldn't fall just on him. They're relatively inexpensive. I think I spent like $180 for it, and that was including the shipping. We officially have our first dirt in the trailer. Well, it's just hay, but brand new trailer's getting dirty. So here I stacked 2-3 strand bales of alfalfa and 2 bales of local. My horses, I feed them free access to local hay all the time, and then they get the alfalfa morning and night for breakfast and dinner. And I'm probably bringing a little bit more than what we need. We're going to be gone for about 10 days. Maybe 4 to 6 of those days are travel days, just depending on how the weather goes and everything. But I want to make sure I have enough of what he's used to so that I'm not buying anything on the road and not knowing what the quality's like and, you know, changing cuttings and all of that for him. I want to minimize any upset possible. So I've portioned out all the grain that we're going to take instead of bringing a whole nother grain bag. So I have Friday through Monday, even though we're planning on coming back that following Sunday, but I like to at least bring one extra in case anything happens. And I am gonna add what the electrolytes and the GastroGuard and things like that into the bags as I feed them, because I might want to adjust what I'm giving or how much I'm giving. The other thing too is I'm bringing alfalfa pellets along for the road so that he has something that I can soak and help him drink some more water. So I'm gonna keep the U-Guard and the electrolytes available, not in my trunk, but in the tack room of the trailer by the water,
where I'm going to keep the alfalfa pellets. That way, when we're on the road, I don't have to try and get past Wiz and into the trunk to give him what he needs. And instead of making more bags, I already have the bag of alfalfa pellets. So instead of doing pre-made bags, I'm just going to scoop from that. So I keep his grain in my trunk. And then I left three more bags available in the buckets that will be in the tack room during the ride. We expect to do the trip in 2 days, but just in case it takes three, then I have three bags already available that I don't have to dig into the trunk to get out. So there you have it. It's all packed in. I even have a little bit of room to spare here. I have a little bit of vet supplies and I think I'm going to just bring some extra tack along as well, you know, in case reins break or something like that, but that'll get put in the tack room. And there it is in its spot in the trailer. See how nicely it all fits into that third spot. And then I don't even think I'll need to really strap anything down. It fits in nice and tight. And then even if he kicks here, the paddy blocks it pretty well. So yeah, it's been a nice little setup that works out pretty well. And for the tack room, we've got saddle, show pads, schooling, working pads, extra halter, helmet, show head stall, extra head stall, extra reins, saddle stand, showed you that stuff. And then I have yet to fill the water tank. That is next. So I'm doing the very last of the packing today. Let's see, I have the cooler to put in. I'm gonna put in the mattress in the sleeping area, so if we need to take a nap someplace during the show, we don't have to run back to the Airbnb. And I thought I would show you guys just a little bit the inside of the new trailer. Here's the comfort area. Mattress will go up top. It's all insulated. It's got some electrical, the boot box, pass-through door. That's the side tack. And I'm gonna add a spot for a microwave, and I think I'm gonna get like a little half fold down table here so I have a spot to eat too. And I can't walk you through to there because it's all packed up. But yeah, very last bit of packing, and we're gonna get hooked up tomorrow before Thanksgiving dinner. And I think we're doing a last oil change. And yeah, that's our pack job to go to Oklahoma. Thank you guys so much for watching, and keep watching the channel to see footage from the NRHA fraternity in Oklahoma City. We leave in 2 days and I'm really excited. We've never done a big trip like that before, so I'll be posting as I can when there's Wi-Fi available. Yeah, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to see all the content and like the videos, comment with your favorite suggestions or things that you'd like to see. See you guys later. Bye.